This is GT here for another YouTube video. And after the election, I guess we'll see what happens. But speaking from a different angle, you know, I just wanted to try to get it into some of your heads out there, those of you who still haven't quite awakened, or maybe, you know, the realization that we're up against people who are not only evil, but, and I mean inherently evil, and one might say psychotic, or yeah, at least antisocial, but more likely sociopathic and or psychopathic in nature. I mean, in their nature. You understand? We're talking about people. These elitist bastards. Who believe that they have the right or the justification, or at least, you know, they do have the attitude that they're somehow better than you. And, you know, they have made a judgment upon you and upon everyone else on the earth, and I assume that, you know, they don't feel like, you know, this is something that they need to be too concerned with about them personally, so that they intend to survive and to thrive, I assume. I guess I better go ahead and say what I'm going to say so you can understand what I'm saying. Okay, these people, the people who are being, you know, run as minions and cohorts and or, you know, mind slaves, I don't know what you call them. They're people who are under the influence of the evil puppet masters, okay? People in high places. And they have this basis of their thinking, or, you know, there's a collected or collective knowledge base from which they draw, and these are intellectuals who are self-chosen prophets of doom and gloom for humanity. But if you understand, if you've been doing like I have for a couple few years now, maybe several, whatever, some years, you begin to understand that they will have this attitude and this, you know, like they're looking down upon you, you know, you're a lowly scumbag, peasant. You understand? And they in their ivory towers and such, or at least in their minds, you know, have decided that you are the scourge of the planet. That there's too many of you. Do you understand? There's too many of you, and you are the bad ones. Okay. If you do as God suggested and be fruitful and multiply, then they hate you. In fact, you know, they've been talking about this and writing about this for, you know, decades, if not, I don't know about centuries, but as far back as I can recall, at least, there's been this kind of, you know, overarching message that we get that, hey, you guys are using too much, you're using up the planet, you know. And there's too many of you. You're just using up too much of the resources. And, you know, they've tried. Although, you know, and quite effectively, at least with their propaganda campaign and brainwashing people about the so-called climate. No, it wasn't climate. It was global warming, specifically. Now, back in the 70s, it was global cooling that they were warning about. And then, when the solar cycle changed... Then they started talking, oh my God, it's going to be, you know, we're going to all burn up. It's an extinction level event. We can't, you know. And it's all our fault. And when they say our fault, they mean you. It's your fault. Because you're alive and you're using up stuff. You know, and you're polluting the freaking world. You're polluting the planet. The planet, the Earth that you live on, is seen as perhaps a living being. Gaia and the New Age movement, that kind of stuff along that line. And or at least they look upon the Earth and natural things on the Earth as being more important than you. You see, you are not to have dominion over the world, the planet, and all of the animals and such on it. You should be subservient and of secondary origin and worth, you know. But anyway, this obviously doesn't include them, because they assume that, you know, they're, since they are superior to the average peasantry person or the, you know, average sheeple or whatever, you know, they take precedence, and of course, you know, they should survive. But you, on the other hand, should perish. And probably in their, you know, in their minds, you know, it should be a horrible thing. You know, let's go back. I mean, these people, it's not, they want to get rid of you. They have, you know, an agenda I want you to know, I want you to understand, the people who are in charge of this world, this planet, the people who, you know, in the intellectual circles, the intellectual elites, the political elites, the so-called, you know, elitists who make up the, you know, the rulers of the world, the groups of people who have taken possession of the planet, and in as a group, say in say like in situations, groups or communities like the UN and other globalist bodies, they are their own collective, you know, and they want to be the hive mind or the hive masters, okay? They want to be a part of the elite. They want to be the controllers, you understand, of the propaganda, of the how you think, what you say, what you do, and all that. But they don't really have your, they're not looking out for you, do you understand? They are doing their best to try to eliminate up to 90% of the population on the earth, you know. And they want, while they're doing that, you know, however way and many different ways in which they are doing that right now. You see, they're not just thinking about it. They're putting the stuff into place. They're putting, they're acting upon the world. They're acting upon their environment to make it so. See, they're not just writing about it, oh, well, you know. Okay, well, you know, if you look back at, like, the predictive programming and, you know, the Brave New World in 1984, these were insiders. The writers, you see, you have to understand, the only people who get published, whose works actually get published and go through the those who go through the process of getting their work vetted, you know, whatever art form or whatever, even science, you know. The only people who get this stuff published are the people who are either in the elitist groups, or they're going to be telling you, you know, hey, this is what we're going to do, and this is how we're going to do it, but in fictional form. It's really, they have to. Somehow there's some kind of spiritual law or rule in which they must tell you what they're going to do before they do it, okay? And I don't know why that is. But I do know that on the good side, with the Lord, that, you know, nothing is done by the Lord without Him going through and telling everybody by His prophets. And, you know, look it up. That's, you know, that's a truism. That is by default patently true. Okay, so let's just apply that same. Maybe there's a rule somehow about that in the spiritual world. I don't know, you know. But the fact is that these people, these so-called elitist bastards, the you know, Club of Rome, the Illuminati camp, you know, the CFR. If you don't know what those are, you really need to know what those are, and you need to look it up. You know, the you know, the camp, the grove, or whatever, the people who, the rich people who, you know, what do you call it? I don't know. I mean, there are circles and groups, the Bilderbergers and all that kind of crap. All those are, you know, associations and congregations and conferences, basically, of, you know, the people who we are talking about are the so-called elitists. And, you know, they are elite. They're elite politicians, elite writers, elite journalists, elite artists, and you know, stuff like that. They're, at least, they're elite to themselves, and they're a self-chosen sanctimonious group of, well, frankly, a-holes who think that they're going to run the world the way that they want it to be run. Well, I mean, you know, that doesn't take into effect, you know, God or God's plans. And most likely, or more times than not, these people don't have anything to do with God, you know, per se. They may claim to be Christians like Obama. But what do they say? What's their message? What are they really trying to tell you? You know, Obama goes over there to Africa and he tells them people right out, you know, just what the predictive programmers have been insinuating. It's like, hey, you know, not everybody's going to be able to go buy a car and a big house and all that. If everybody did, you know, the planet would burn up. You know, you can't have air conditioning. My Lord, no! You'll use up all the resources. You see what I'm saying? You know, you can't have a car. You see? And this is while this guy's, you know, taking spending millions of dollars per day and using, you know, he flies in his own airplane. Yeah. You know, we're talking about a guy who plays golf for a living. You know, I mean, basically, he spends more time on the golf course, and that costs somebody else money to do, than anything. You know, and here's the guy, you know, the leader, the science czar, Holdren. Now, back in the day, he wrote a book called Eco-Science, okay, or he co-authored back in the 70s, in fact. It's kind of hard to believe. But in that book, you know, and I have a copy of it, I have a copy of all these instances where he says stuff that is, like, way out there, or at least seemingly, you know. You know, like, okay, let's put sterilants in the water and all this kind of stuff, food and water, poison the food and water, basically, to keep the population down. You understand? They are eugenicists extraordinaire, but they're not really like racist eugenicists. They just want to kill everybody except them. You see, although they do kind of seem to pick on the Africans quite a bit, and most of their programs start out with them as the guinea pigs, whether they be in Africa or of African descent in America, which may be, you know, why they, you know, I don't know, but they think that they're better in general. And, you know, I've seen these Bilderberg groups, CFR groups, and all that such. And most of them, I'd say, I rarely see, I don't know if I've ever seen a person of color in those groups. I don't know. So maybe there is a racist kind of a thing there too. But I don't know. It's not a verified type of thing. You know what I mean? Although it probably has a certain degree of truth to it. But see, and like people like Bill Gates and you know, who's that bastard who goes around with the ice cream cone? A billionaire. Jeez. I can't think of his name right offhand, but it's like a mental block or whatever. Whatever, you know. Hathaway. No. I can't. You know? Freakin' memory. Well, anyway, my brain will keep working on that in the background without me knowing about it, and it'll pop up later, because that's the way things work. Anyway, so these people, they say ridiculous things like Bill Gates gets up on the TED conference, and I don't know if you've seen the clips or whatever, but you know, he's got a formula up on the screen behind him. And, you know, it's got, you know, like CO2 and equals, you know, number of people times the amount of stuff they use and all that and blah, blah, blah. It's a formula, an equation. Well, you know, and he's going, you know, somehow or another, we're going to have to get this down to zero, as close to zero as we can get. Which means one of these numbers is going to have to go down to zero, or close to it. You know, and he's insinuating, like, you know, and one of those numbers is the population, you see. Number of people. So he's, in, you know, he's getting the message, you know, one of these numbers got to go down to zero, you know, that means like you, not him, you see, not him, but you. And just the idea, the insane idea that carbon dioxide has to go down to zero is just like, what, you know. Plants use CO2, you know, and right now, if you look at the cycles of CO2, and if you've done any research whatsoever to inform yourself, which I do suggest that you do, because, you know, only a moron speaks from parroting other people and stupid ideas that they hear on the news and to media, like global warming, okay? You know, I'm not going to go into how that changed into climate change, which is like, duh! Anyway, the thing is that, you know, he says, you know, we should either be aiming for zero population or zero CO2, or, you know, that's what it comes down to. And see, the truth comes out in that, what he said. He's actually telling what he's telling you. You know, we got to eliminate these people. There's too many people. You know, since back in the 70s, you know, when I was a teenager, and they were trying to tell us, you know, okay, man, the earth's all polluted, and you guys did this. And you got, you know, you got to take care of the earth and all that. But you know what? It's the people who are in charge, the so-called elites, who are the responsible parties. They're the people who own the industries who have run amok and ruined the earth and poisoned the earth with their chemicals, their petrochemicals, their waste chemicals, their waste byproducts, their herbicides, their pesticides, their suicides. I mean, the freaking elite, are the ones who own the industry and the corporations that made the mess. It's not us. We're just using their products. You know, the people, I mean, you know, just using their products, we're not polluting the whole freaking world, you know. Unless their products are really bad, you know. Mostly what it is all of the, you know, the environmental damage done through, you know, they're just releasing crap into the, you know, they use the rivers and the lakes and the oceans for a toilet or a garbage dump or whatever, and then they blame it on us. Hey, you guys gotta quit doing that, you know. You gotta quit polluting the earth, you bastards. And that's really, I mean, that should be maddening to you. And it is to me. It's them doing it. They're polluting, they're destroying, and then they're blaming you and making you pay for the cleanup. You know, which is always, you know, 10 times worse than just not getting it. You know, it's like, okay, if I don't drop this mercury into this water, then I won't have to spend like hours and $100,000 to clean it up. You know, to get it out of there, to extract it. You know, and of course it wouldn't be perfect. You see what I'm saying? It's them who are really responsible for the mess. Yet they blame it on us, and then they use that to justify within their mind that we should be eliminated. You know, we are not worthy to live on their planet, is what it is. You are not worthy and not justified to have life or liberty or property on their planet. That's really what it comes down to. These are the people who are under the powers of the principalities and the powers of darkness which rule the earth. They are the kings, the rulers, and the minions of Satan himself. Really? I mean, think about it. What kind of sick bastard would dream up such a thing? You know what I'm saying? You know, let's poison the water, let's poison the food, and then they do it. See, it's not just talking. They have been doing it to you. BPA in your every canned good, every bottled water. You know, it's lined with BPA, which is a toxic hormone, estrogen mimetic, which feminizes men and gives cancer and other bad estrogenic effects to women, including, well, cancer especially, but, you know. And this stuff is ubiquitous, you know, it's all over, you can't get away from it. You know, and there's fluoride in your water and all kinds of chemicals and pharmaceuticals. There's glyphosate in the water. The glyphosate, you know, every decade since the invention of the petrochemical industrial complexes, you know, or whatever. I mean, you know, what you have to understand is that, you know, they're not, these people are not your friends. They are your enemies. They are arch enemies. And yeah, who has arch enemies, you know? You do. You just don't know it because they're not telling you. Oh, by the way, we're poisoning your food and your water slowly so that you die, get sick, get into the medical complex, and then we kill you and treat you with some more medications that will finish you off in such a way that we profit, and then when you're dead, then we got everything. Ta-da. It's kind of like that. It's like, you know, see, they have this idea that they're going to be transformed into, you know, some kind of perhaps in the beginning, probably some kind of, you know, transhumanism is what they call it, and you know, and they're thinking, well, you know, we're going to become, you know, stronger, faster, you know, better, blah blah blah, with bionic type implants, and then this is going to evolve over time into their actually downloading their essence or whatever into some kind of machine so that they can live forever. See what I'm saying? I mean, they're talking about it. Look at what they're saying. They're saying, like, by 2025 or something, you know, that will be possible. So, I mean, they're gearing up for it. When that occurs, then we will actually, as humans, you know, on the planet, the rest of us who don't have, like, mega millions of dollars and we're not, like, elitist bastards, well, then we're going to have to die, you see. And maybe they've already kind of, you know, well, let's just start working on that now. Because, you know, the technology is rolling along, and, you know, pretty soon we're going to, you know, why wait to get rid of these bastards, you know, when we can start, you know, getting rid of them now. So, you're going to see the things that are prophesied in the Bible. You're going to have wars and rumors of wars. You're going to have famines. You're going to have pestilences, and you know, it's like, you know, the Ebola thing, we're out there, like, picking proxy war fights with, like, everybody in the Middle East, and we're picking on Iran and Russia, and, you know, I mean, it's like freaking insane. What the hell? People, I'm trying to get you to understand, the group of so-called elitists, are out there. They've been talking about how bad you are, and they have put out, you know, stuff like, we're going to poison the food, we're going to sterilize these bastards. And what have they done? They have poisoned us. They have poison in the food. They have poison in the water. The preservatives, the chemicals, petrochemicals, the soy, the GMOs, genetically modified organisms. It's not food. My God, it's genocide. Don't you get it? GMO is genocide method and organization. Or mode of operation. Genocidal mode of operation. How about that? GMO. There's your freaking acronym that you can get your head around. It's to kill you. Everything that they said is a lie about GMOs. It doesn't increase yield. It doesn't increase ability for the plants to be stronger or more resistant to disease or heat or weather conditions. It doesn't do any of that, and the yields are so poor that, you know, they got the Indian farmers in India. They got those farmers convinced, you know, they lied to them. You know, who would have thought they'd lie, you know, for money's sake? Oh, no, not that. You know, they tell these guys, hey, you know, you start using these crops and your yields are going to go through the roof, man. You're going to get rich and blah, 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 blah. What happens in reality when they plant? It kills, you know, and then they use glyphosate on the ground, which goes into the water, which goes into them. Glyphosate, you know, sterilant, killer. You know, you got your DDT, you got your, you know, your Agent Orange, you got your glyphosate. Who made all those again? Oh, Monsanto, the guy about, yeah, the food guy. It's not a guy. It's a chemical corporation. Syngenta, Dow, Monsanto, the chemical corporations that are poisoning you. Poisoning the ground, poisoning the water we drink, the ground we take our food out of. They are poisoning it with their freaking chemicals. Don't you get it? I mean, what the hell is wrong with you? If you don't understand that these people are poisoning the land, they're poisoning the water, and you live off the water, and you live off the land. Everything that you buy to eat or to drink has some poisons in it. And more than likely, if you live in the United States, most of the food that you eat is not even really food. You know, look it up. Soy is in everything. Why? It's not food. It's a chemical. It is the purveyor of a so-called natural mimetic of estrogen, which is exactly what they need to sterilize you. You are being sterilized as a species, as a bunch of stupid sheeple that you are. Deceived. Naive, trusting, stupid, deceived people. And we call them sheeple. And we call them sleeple. So, if you're one of those people who thinks that things, you know, the politicians in the world is every la la la, this hasn't changed, and there's nothing bad, nothing to worry about, everything's all right, you know, and it'll be okay, and all that, wake up! It ain't. You're dying, you're being killed. You're being poisoned, and it's all on purpose. It's planned. It's written down. They told you they're going to do it, and how they're going to do it, and they have done it. if you look at 1984 and look at all of the ridiculous things that are in there, well, we have one-upped every one of them. It is much worse than anybody ever wrote about, if the reality be known. And Holdren's eco-science, and all of these other writers of the so-called elitist Illuminatis and all that crap are published, written, and they have told you that, you know, you need to die. You need to, you know, perhaps it'd be best if you just, you know, commit Harry Carey or suicide or whatever, so we don't have to kill you, but, you know, in case you don't, we're going to go ahead with our, you know, long-term processes and slow kill of poisoning, slow poisoning, ensuring that you will go through their medical system and they can sell you pharmaceuticals to further poison your body for the rest of your life or for your, you know, the entire days of your life. If you, you know, what's the only industry left in the United States? Boy, think hard. You got food, you got medical. You got food, you got medical. I wonder who's in those. Maybe the elitists have something to do with that. Maybe they own those. So they're selling you the food. They own the chemical companies that are poisoning you. And poisoning the land. And poisoning the water. And then they're blaming it on you and telling you that you're using too many freaking resources, so you need to die. You know. Because, you know, you're creating global warming. Or is it cooling? Or is it just change? You're creating, somehow or another, you're responsible for global climate change now. You know what? Those bastards. You know what I say? I say F them. You know, F them all. You guys need to wake up. And you need to freaking figure this stuff out. I already know. I'm telling you the truth. I don't have an agenda. I'm not making any money. You know, I'm not being supported by anybody. I'm just telling you the truth. And if you don't like it, well, you know, you can just switch me right off. Push that damn button. Turn me off. Or you can start looking up stuff yourself and testing things, test everything, and hold on to that which is good. And I'll tell you what's not good is the way that the world is running and the people who are running it. And, you know, you can vote all you want, but they own the voting machines, you understand? And they own the software and the back door to get in there. And they've got all kinds of other little shenanigans to make things happen the way they want it to do. So, you know, be prepared to pick up a rifle or something and fight these people some way soon. Because, you know, the species fan convergence is rapidly approaching. And I'm warning you, you know. Well, that's all I got to say for today. I'm going to cut out with peace, love, and power, a blessing upon all viewers and listeners. And may God bless each and every one of the listeners and the viewers. And good day to you.